the bang, like, ha ha ha. I'm laughing at the slang, like, ha ha ha.
Yes, it's finally back. The championship. Best league in the world. Full of playoff excitement. The results, you can never ever guess what's going to happen. I mean, just look at last season. Look at Barnsley. How they managed to finish in playoffs. Now that they've lost their manager, everyone thinks they're going to finish mid-table or whatnot. So, we have no idea. We've got the excitement of these newly promoted teams. Like Blackpool and Peterborough. They've got some dangerous teams coming up. But how do I think it's going to finish? I mean, I think I've come up with a decent guess on how it's going to finish. Might be a bit boring. I think few are a bit crazy, but it's the championship. It is a crazy league. So then, let's get straight into it. We're going to go from the bottom upwards. So whoever finishes bottom will be first. And in my opinion, I feel like it's the obvious one, but it's got to be Derby. They're in such utter state at the minute. They're all over the place. I mean, not just in transfers, but there's just complete lack of organisation going on at the club. There's, it looks like there's barely any transfers coming in. There's stories of Rooney sleeping in his office to try and get at least some transfers done. They barely have even a squad of players. I don't know how they're going to field a team. And it's not like they've got a really experienced manager in charge. Rooney's got no experience, especially with this. You know, you need a manager who's going to really put the hard work in to get to save your team from going down. Rooney barely got his own sort of style of play and tactics going on. So it's going to be an absolute, you know, terrible season for Derby. I don't feel like it's impossible for them to get out. I mean, they are working on transfers. If they get a few done, they should be in a good place. But, I mean, they just don't look good at the minute. If they get a few transfers done, and I think Rooney could inspire the team a bit, they could survive, but I'm going to put them last. Now for 23rd, second bottom, I think it's going to be Blackpool. Well, I don't really want to say it because I'm happy they've been promoted, but their team doesn't look like they have the sort of level. The Championship's a tough league, and they remind me of the way Wickham looked last season, and obviously they struggled quite a bit. They could have got out, but they struggled a bit. I think Blackpool will definitely struggle. I think they'll stick together and they'll have a decent season, but I do think they'll go down. I'd like to see them stay up, but I'm not sure else who's going to go down. I feel like they have to go down. And they did come up through playoffs. So every team that comes through playoffs, it looks like you're going to go back down after. I've seen some of the business they've done, and I think one important bit is that they've kept Jerry Yates and given him a new deal. That's very important that they did that. But the signings they've made are sort of Blackpool quality, not Championship quality. They're not going to be able to use those players correctly to stay up. But I do believe as a team, and obviously with the fans behind them now in the stadiums, they do have great chemistry. And I do think, you know, they'll give teams a good win for their money. They'll put up some surprising results. But I do think in the end, overall, they will go down again, which is a shame. I would like to see them stay up. I hope they do, but I just think they're going to be 23rd. Now for 22nd. Yes, I think it's going to be Peterborough. I mean, they've got a good team, they've got a good youngsters, but once again, I think it's a bit like Blackpool situation. They've just not got the level of players that I think will keep them up. I think they definitely have some very, very talented players, but not as a team. Like, if Clark Harris can bounce off the season he's just had, and if they obviously keep him, because there's interest from other clubs, they keep him and he has a good season again, then why not? Why can't they stay up? But I think as a team, obviously they're very good with these young players and turn them into crazy good players. Like, just look at the likes of Ivan Toney and what he's broken Glenn Murray's record the season he left. So they do have some good youngsters in their team, but I don't think they're going to get very far. I do believe they'll give relegation a good run for its money, and a lot of teams are good, you know, that they'll get some good results under them. But I think they definitely can survive, obviously, if their team works really well. But once again, they've not got the quality of staying up in the Championship, so I think they'll go back down. Now, who do I think will just about survive relegation? Hull City. Now, I think they could definitely get relegated too, and that's why they're just outside of it. I think if Peterborough have a better season than them, they'll go there. Maybe Blackpool surprise them, and Peterborough and Hull both go bad, they get relegated. Maybe all three of them go down and Derby stay up, I'm not sure. But I do think out of the three promoted teams, Hull look the best. They've got some good talented players there. You look at Wilkes, and it's just a very, very good team. Obviously, Peterborough got a good team too, but I think Hull are ever so slightly better. And they could definitely be relegated. I think they're here just outside of it because they can interchange with those teams that are in the relegation zone. But I think they'll be a very good team, and I do think they'll probably stay up. I think, they have they're on the high of just being promoted and should have a good oomph behind their team, put a good battle in, and I do think they'll survive pretty comfortably. They'll be battling for most of the season, but they'll survive. Now it's for some more relegation battlers. Huddersfield. I do think Huddersfield will be down this low. Such a big fall from grace. Really doesn't seem that long ago since we were seeing them in the Premier League, with some great players and that. But currently, they've looked like every season their team has just deteriorated and slowly got worse and worse. And I think they're really going to struggle this season. I don't think they'll go down, though. That's why they're here in 20th. I think they'll be all right. They'll battle with these teams. They'll beat the teams that are really low. But any team mid-table is like a tough challenge for them, and they're lucky to get points off. But, I think they'll have a decent season for them anyway. Nowhere near mid-table, I don't think. It will be relegation battle, but they'll definitely survive. Now, here's another team I think will struggle a little bit. As much as I like them and I'd like to see them stay in the Championship, I do think they will, and that's why they're here. But Coventry, they look like a team. They've got some decent players, obviously, but they're not really mid-table level, but they're also not going down. They're right in the middle, and that's why they're here. I think they're a good team. They'll give some teams surprising results. They'll really test some teams, but I really don't think they'll be, pushing too far away from those relegation zones. But, that they will survive, I'm pretty sure. I mean, they had a decent season last season. I think they'll carry that on this year. Another team that's struggling a bit. And to be honest, I do think they maybe they could finish below Coventry. But, give them benefit of the doubt. I'm hopeful that they'll be able to push on. But I think Preston will be here. They've just fallen a lot. I mean, they've never been a team looking like getting playoffs. They've always looked like a mid-table team. But after this transfer window and the season before, they look like they're really dropping off and becoming not a mid-table team, but a relegation battler. Obviously, I don't think they're too far off, but they're looking in the worst shape they've been for the last few years. They don't look a good team anymore. I mean, every time you used to go to Preston and play them, you think this is going to be quite a tough game. Wish you can wear with a win, but, it would be a tough match. But now I think they're an easy point game. You can easily get points off them. So that's why I've put them here. Next, I think it's the Blues. Birmingham City, they are going to be here. They've made a few good signings, but they tend to do that every season. They make, some really good additions to their team. Some players you think, wow, that's a good signing. Or how have they done that, And then they turn around, you get to the season, and it's the same stuff they put every season. They give the fans so much hope, and then it turns into nothing. I do think they've got some really good players that they brought in, and now I think more than ever they have a good manager behind them. Lee Bowyer is a good manager. And I don't think they'll get too far. I see some of the fans saying playoffs. I don't think that's going to get there. But I do think they're going to have a good season and finish mid-table. And it will definitely be a big improvement from last year. But once again, they make these signings and they somehow don't pay off. But I think with Bowyer in charge, I think he's going to turn a few of their players that got there into good players. And they're going to finish mid-table-ish. I think just above Blues in 16th is going to be Bristol. Now, I see a lot of people putting them really low down. I do think, they've not got the great quality of the team they maybe used to have. And they've obviously released, half their team on a free this season. The main striker, that Diadu, we all know from Cammy not being able to pronounce.
From Famara Diadu.
To increasing that league with Famara Diadu.
That's the funniest video I've ever seen. It's Famara Diadu. Not that I you, Jeju.
He's a good player, and they've lost him. They've lost quite a few players on a free with their contracts running out. So, yeah, they're a weaker team now, but, you know, they've done a bit of business, and I think, you know, they're going to get mid-table. They're not going to be the most exciting club, and I don't think it's anywhere near a playoff push. But I do think they'll finish around mid-table, lower parts of mid-table. And, yeah, I think it's reasonable to put them here. And now it's for a team that are definitely on the low. I mean, losing a manager, probably going to lose a few key players. I mean, most of them are on loan. Look at Daryl Dyke. You know, he's no longer there now. He's gone back to Orlando. And, you know, they've lost the manager that bought the style of play that got them into that playoff position at the end. You know, I think they've still got, you know, most of their good players there, like Callum Stiles, you know, he's a fantastic player. But with a new manager in charge, I'm not sure of this manager. I've never heard of him before. I'm sure he's a good manager, yeah, but how is he going to make Barnsley play? Is he going to bring back that playoff push? Or are they going to turn into a relegation candidate? Maybe they'll be really bad. Or are they going to just sit mid-table and be a decent team that, you know, put up some good results all season? I'm not really sure what they're going to do, but, you know, I think this is probably a fair place to put them. Just above them, I think a team that will improve from last year, but not to the, you know, places they've been before. Obviously, you know, win two Champions Leagues, they're nowhere near that. But I don't think they're near playoffs. I think they're mid-table. They're going to improve from what they did last season, because, I mean, last season was very bad. But, you know, they've kind of got a bit more stability going on in the club now, rather than being all over the place like they were last year. And I think mid-table is a, you know, a good shout for them. I do think they'll finish there. Finish above, you know, way away from relegation, be nowhere near it. But I think, you know, that they do need an improvement from last year. And I think this season's definitely going to be that. I think they're not going to get too far, not going to have playoffs. They'll be nowhere near promotion for, I think, the next two or three seasons, unless they make some huge signings to get some huge investment. So I think putting them here is probably fair. Now a team on the downfall from last season, you know, losing a key player, Elise. I think Reading will be mid-table. I don't think they've not got the good enough team to be in playoffs again. I mean, they obviously didn't get playoffs last year, but they were very, very close and were in that top six for a majority of the season. I think, obviously, you saw they fell off end of last season, but losing Elise as well now, they're definitely going to fall off. They still got Lucas Jao, obviously a very good striker, but is he going to produce the same numbers this year? I hope he does. I hope Reading get playoffs. But realistically speaking, I think they're going to finish about, you know, around here, top of mid-table, but quite far away from playoffs. Another team I think will have a pretty good improvement from last year and have a decent season. Obviously, you know, Blackburn, they look like they might lose Armstrong to either Southampton or Norwich. And I've seen him linked with, you know, a ton of other places too. But I think, you know, if obviously they get a good replacement striker in, there's a few going round, then, you know, I think not playoffs, maybe if they have a really good season and surprise. But I think they will be about mid-table. I think maybe I'll put them a bit too high. I think Reading, if they have a good season, obviously be above them. Forest, if they have a really good season, you know, above them. But I think, once again, it's a team that's going to sit around mid-table and has the ability, if they play really well, to get nearer to those playoff spots. Up next is Stoke. Now, Stoke always have a good team. They have, like, a decent team. But they somehow never manage to do well. And, of course, you know, Stoke mentality maybe doesn't work anymore. That's sort of, you know, hard to play against. Really annoying, solid team. Maybe they've not got exactly the way it used to be when they're in the Premier League. You know, football's changed a little bit since then, so maybe that style of play isn't what they need. But they have got some quality players. Obviously, I think most of them are the wrong age of, you know, getting close to 30, but they've got a good team. They just never really seem to do well, as you would expect them to do with those type of players. They're always sort of off, nowhere near playoffs, always sat there mid-table. So I'm thinking this year I'm going to give a bit more of a chance. I mean, you know, it'll probably be this a bit the same again. You know, boring Stoke. mid-table as usual. But I'd like to see them push for those playoff spots. And I think they can. They've got the team too. So I'm going to put them here. Next up is Swansea. Now, I don't know what to expect from Swansea. You know, different manager, different players, different style going on at the minute. Especially with, the new badge, which, to be fair, I like. But that's not important. Where they're going to finish. Now, I have no idea. They're a good team still, but I don't think they're playoff ready. Especially with the new manager that we don't know what he's going to do. Obviously, if they still had, the manager from before, they'd probably be pushing for playoffs. But I don't really know what to expect from Swansea this year. They might be incredible and finish in the top four, maybe going for an automatic. But personally, I don't see them getting that close to playoffs. I mean, they have made a few good signings. That new Dutch striker, I'm not sure how you pronounce his name, but it's like Piora, something like that, I don't know. He looks decent, but they've not made too many amazing signings to look like, wow, that's a statement they're going to be battling. So I don't think they're going to get playoffs this year and they're going to finish here. In ninth is Luton. Now, I think at this point you're probably questioning, maybe you are stupid, why have you put them here? But I think Luton are a good team. They're obviously not the biggest team you've ever seen in the world. They're not going to be in those top spots all season. But they'll be pushing for them. I think they've got a good team, good players. Not Prem level, so they obviously won't be getting promoted. If they do, it's because they win playoffs. And at that, they'll come straight back down if they get anywhere close. But I think Luton will give teams a run for the money, again, as they do every season. They surprise a lot of teams. And maybe I've put them a bit too high up. Maybe they'll be a bit lower down, depending on how their season is. If they play bad, a bit lower. If they play maybe better than this. I think this is if they play their best, they finish here. Now it's time for the mighty Millwall. Why have I put them here? Because they're a good team. I think they've got great players. They lack, good quality in some places. That's why they're not in playoffs. But I think every season they've been close. I think ever since 2019 season, they've got close to playoffs, but fell off at important points in the season, lost important points. I think if they can go into games with a bit more of a positive mentality and get those points and those wins on the board, they could definitely get into playoffs very easily. That's why I've not put them in playoffs, because I'm not sure if they're going to do that. I think they'll fall off again, as they always do. And I'll think they will finish in 8th. Next, I think it'll be Middlesbrough. Maybe this is a bit crazy again. Maybe this is another one that's just absolutely nuts. But you look at the transfers that they've done, the work that Warnock has done on the team, both transfers and in just, development of their players.
That's a load of bollocks! You've got to fucking die to get 3 points!
They look like a real dangerous team going into this season. And I think they will definitely push on and definitely push for those playoff spots. I'm not sure maybe if Warnock's tactics are going to really do that for them.
Have a fucking word with him then, Red!
But I'm hopeful for them. I think they will push on and definitely push for those playoff spots. I think, Warnock, we all know him, one of the greatest managers we've ever seen, just for funny reasons more than anything. And I think he'll, put a good stamp on this Middlesbrough team. Now it's playoffs in 6th. Who will get the bottom, playoff spot? Who'll just creep in there and get it? I think it's between Middlesbrough and Cardiff. That's why Middlesbrough were 7th. I think Middlesbrough, I just can't see them in playoffs. I can't see them a team in playoffs. Obviously, it's the Championship and, everything's backwards half the time. So I think maybe Middlesbrough can get in there, but, there's another team here that's going to be battling for that last spot in the playoffs, and it will be Cardiff, I think. A good team. I mean, they've got Kiefer Moore up front. He's an international player. Obviously, they're missing Harry Wilson now. He was an important part of their success last year. He's now at Fulham. And I think they'll push for this playoff spot. Whether they get it, I'm not too sure. It depends if they go get on a good run and get important points from important games. And hopefully they'll be able to get into that spot. Fifth, I think the QPR fans are probably surprised they haven't seen their name lower down. But I'm really hopeful for them. You know, looking at the players they've got and the way they performed in pre-season. Look at the, you know, the win they got against Man United and then the draw, the 3-3 draw they got against Leicester. And I'm not sure if they did any other good games, but those are two that I remember seeing. They look a dangerous team. You know, they've got, you know, Charlie Austin and that Leidendijk, I think that's how you say his first name, not too sure, but them two up front are going to, you know, get a great partnership. They're putting some, you know, an amazing amount of good players all over the players, midfield, defence, everywhere. And I think they are going to be a real, really, really good team this season, and I think they'll get playoffs. I don't think they'll win playoffs. Depends how their season goes and how good of a run they go on. But I think they'll finish fifth. Now, I think from fourth upwards is people who can contend those two automatic spots, you know, winning the title and being second. But I think fourth will be Sheffield United. Now, I'd like to see them, you know, come straight back up. But I think without Wilder and a new manager being here, obviously he's a, you know, decent manager, but I think a whole different mentality is going on at the moment, and I'm not too sure how they're going to do, but I don't think they'll, you know, get those two automatic spots. They'll be just out of it. That's why I put them fourth. I think they'll probably be the team that wins the playoffs and comes back up, but otherwise I don't think they're going to be doing amazing, and they'll probably get fourth. Third, I've put Bournemouth. Now, maybe, you know, they've had their opener game. We've seen how these are played. We're not seeing how anyone else has played yet, apart from West Brom as well. But I'm not sure still what to expect from them. Obviously, they've got Scott Parker in charge. You know, they didn't play Dan Juma yesterday against West Brom. So, I don't know if that, if Dan Juma stays, which doesn't look like he will. But if he does, maybe they get into those top two spots. Maybe they, and you know what I said about Sheffield United, they'll win playoffs. I think whoever doesn't get the automatic spot will fail in the final. I feel like Sheffield United will just be solid. They'll be like, we didn't get automatics, we weren't close to it, we're going to have to push in playoffs. And this third team, whoever it is going to struggle. And I think it'll be Bournemouth. Now it's into the automatics. Who will get these automatic spots? I think second, obviously, would be competing with Sheffield United and Bournemouth. But I think it'll be Fulham in second. Obviously, they've got one of, I think, looks like the strongest squad in the Championship. You know, all round. Obviously, bringing in Harry Wilson. We know how good he is. But I think they'll be second. Why do I think that? If they've got such a good team, because they've not really got a fantastic manager. Losing Scott Parker, I think, is going to be a big blow to, you know, their promotion challenge. I think they'll still do it because their team is just so, you know, so good. Obviously, with Mitrovic, we know how good he is in the Championship. You know, Rodak will be in goal again now, most likely. And be like an improved team than what brought them up last time. So I think they'll come up. But whether they win the league, I'm not too sure. It depends on the way, you know, the new manager coming in, how the team play. But I think if they work too well as a team and the tactic comes through perfectly, they could definitely win the league. And if other teams around them, like West Brom and that, don't play as well, they definitely could. Now for the final players, the title winners. Obviously, there's no bias here, considering I am a West Bromwich Albion fan. But I think we'll win the league. Now, do I really think that? I don't know. If the team works the way it looks like it's going to work. Obviously, you've seen them in the opening game against Bournemouth, another promotion challenger that I've put third. I think automatics is a must. I don't want playoffs. I don't think anyone wants playoffs, but I don't want it. I want an automatic finish. Do we win the league? I'm not sure. It depends how well Fulham play. I think more than anything, I think we're definitely going to sit in those top two. Whether we win the league depends on the way Fulham play. But that's it for my championship prediction video. I think I've put some outrageous things in there with, like, you know, QPR and Luton. Maybe I've put people a bit too low down. Maybe I should be expecting better of some teams. Whatever you think, put in the comments. I'd like to see what you think. But I hope you all enjoyed this video. I know it's just me rambling on about the championship. But if you did, make sure you leave a like and subscribe. And I'll see you soon.